10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. Coming out of the end zone, D. Eskridge. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Here's Walker to start the drive. And an early how do you do right there as they're going to bury him in the backfield. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
An awful lot of congestion in the middle third of the field, but how about our defensive tackle right there? He didn't just hold the line. He provided some push and smacked the ball carrier down for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now a play fake, and here's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So, CD, this defense, they know that they have to be at their very best when they're taking on a team here that's in the midst of a winning streak that's now stretched over multiple months, not weeks, months.
I think the challenge they put upon themselves is we want to be the guys to end that streak. And what's working in their favor? The winning streak on the other side. Sometimes that carries a burden with it.
Because no escape for Rock, and we'll go down. And now that brings up fourth down there. Loss of 6 yards on the sack. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. And the win last week, punted four times as this one's away. That's taken on the 25. A nice run back there off the good punt. It's a 16-yard return. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll be pretty well stopped at his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42. Well, this defense for the Seahawks, they were strong last week, CD, and that went over New England.
And I think our statistician, we ended up having to bring the blue tent and put it around him for a while because he was developing a hand injury from having to write down all the turnovers this team forced. 5, 6, 7, 8. Absolutely unbelievable. I hope he'll recover.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and 2 now.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Hands it off out of the gun. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. The Packers at 2-7 now on the year. Well, they were losers last time out, trying to turn things around here in this one.
And it always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement as long as you give them something good to cheer about. So, you know, they just want to come out and play well for their faithful, and I expect them to do just that.
From the gun, they'll try to run it, and he'll take this one down to about the 40. Kenneth Murray, the linebacker, there to make the play defensively.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Second and 9. Rodgers. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Call it a loss of 5. A big sack to bring up third down.
You've called plenty of games in your career. Do you believe in momentum, my man?
I do, and I think we're seeing it right here.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. The run that he's been on. How about that? Three sacks in a game a week ago, and another one right here. Oh, he's feeling it in a big way.
Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Throwing now is Rodgers. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free. And it brings up fourth down. On fourth down, Michael Pilardi on to punt. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed. And that's caught inside the 35. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. Another milestone falling on that last throw in what has been an MVP-type season so far, as he has now gone over 4,000 yards passing already on the year.
And it's been a whole lot of fun to watch as he's put together this type of a season. And to me, you have to figure, with so many games remaining,
and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Rashawn Gary that time fighting free and getting to the quarterback.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
After the sack on first down, Lock. And that's incomplete.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Locke. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. To throw it is Locke. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing? That's three sacks now. And this team came into the game in the bottom five in the league in sacks.
Yeah, this
What's
is
going
not,
on?
It's not been their bread and butter. I don't know, is a blind squirrel finding a nut, or is it something they can build on?
Well, they found some momentum. They found a crack in that offensive line, and they're putting it to good use.
To try again after the sack. Lock. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I came into this game eager to see how they would hold up the man coverage. But on that play, they held up quite well.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Lock gonna throw. And this is caught. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. No score after one on EA Sports. first and goal. From the gun, it's Locke. A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Walker is going backwards as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
The Seahawks on third down, they've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here. Locke going to keep this. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out, and the Packers pick it up.
They give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but that's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field, and he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
Instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And they take over in a precarious spot here, albeit after forcing the fumble at the goal line. This is safety territory. And oh, that is gonna be a safety. So after a scoreless first quarter, we at least finally get some points on the board.
But it can't be what either of us expected, can it?
No, the safety's not what you expect for the first points of the game, but one of the goose eggs is gone. Taken in at the 11. Seahawks with a first and 10. Locke gets ready to go. At their own 11. Following the fumble recovery, it's Locke. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 38. For Drew Locke coming out of Missouri, the one thing that scouts, they loved was his arm strength. And we see why there.
And that's how you start a drive, because you know they had this play in their back pocket, waiting for the right time to unleash it. And boy, did they pick the right opportunity. Unleashed it big time, and that was also a big time throw.
Block off of play action. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And this ball incomplete. Looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. Second down coming up.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Locke going to run a little touch pass here to his wideout.
That was a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Shotgun snap to Locke. Oh, he's thinking end zone for Evans. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Mike Evans, his 14th touchdown now on the year, as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes this a 9-point game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better here on this still on his feet. And he will finally be escorted out of bounds down inside the 35. A big play there on the catch and run. 42 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And they'll run on the inside handoff. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
Well, there's an example of patience being rewarded. Ran the ball on first down and got stuffed. Most people would scream, throw the ball here in this situation. They stayed with their roots, stayed with running the football, and they got rewarded.
This down to the 18, good enough for a first down. That one goes for 8 yards. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're in the bottom five in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on third and what, right? I bet they're in the top five in the league on third and five, third and six, third and seven or more, because that's how you end up not converting. Just too much yardage to pick up on third down.
A gain of 3, second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Throw right side. This is into the hands of the tight end, Tonyan. And it's a Packers touchdown. Robert Tonyan, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers are back within a score. Extra point up and through. And the lead is down to 2. So the Packer kickoff team set to go as they will kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
To throw again on second down. Lock. Airing this one out for Evans. And this one is incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Play action. Now it's Lock. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 18. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And out will come the offense as they take over. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You could never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
That was a particularly nice play because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done. And the Seahawks add a couple of extra DBs going with the dime look here.
Indeed, six on the field. Throwing is Rodgers. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. From the gun, it's Rodgers. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver.
And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Rodgers now, after the sack, he'll lead the pack up on third and long. Hands it off out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say, we'll see what happens. So on fourth down, kicking it away here, Michael Pilardi. And he'll back up a few steps as he'll make the fair catch at about the 8-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they'll begin inside their own 10, so field position certainly not in their favor here. A final shot before half for Locke. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. So we have reached halftime here in a tight 2-point contest. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. Taken in at the 3. And he won't quite make it to the 25. offense ready to get their next drive underway. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well, and they've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
Now here's a throw that's complete. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first down, Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. That's Lynch. It'll be a gain of five at its second down.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Ball at the 40 here for second and five. To throw is Rodgers, and he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down.
Multiple players getting home for the 1 yard sack,
and for the defense, their third sack of the game.
That number tells you that they're starting to put it together with their defensive game plan. They're starting to feel pretty good about what the offense is doing, bringing the pressure at the right time and putting the quarterback on the ground.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Lynch. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Run got three. Now here's second and seven. Rodgers now to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker, and the Seahawks are going to have it here at their own 32-yard line.
There's any other way to put it, but that was just simply deflating, because you know they came out ready to go at halftime, right? Everyone motivating each other, wanting to get out there and get going, and that turnover absolutely saps your momentum. Now you're just shouting encouragement to your defense, hoping they can pick you up and give you another chance.
After the turnover, here's Locke. He'll buy some time right. Airing this one out for Evans. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Whenever you see a quarterback break contain, just think to yourself, the receivers on that side of the field, their number one job, make sure they get in his sight line so he can try and find someone downfield. Guys on the backside, make sure you don't give up the deep ball. They tried it there. They weren't able to connect.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic. Well over it.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
On first and 10, here's Locke. And completes it again to Metcalf. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. To throw again on second down. Locke. He's able to find Melton. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Again, it's Locke. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Mike Evans, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes this a 9-point game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taken at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in this second half. Accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. On second down, here's Rodgers. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, he leads the NFL in interceptions and nearly added to that total.
Got his hand on it, couldn't quite corral it. It's been a Pro Bowl-type season for him, and the term ball hawk really comes into play, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that one a lot because teams want to avoid that type of a player, but sometimes you just can't. He just knows where the ball is.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Here's Michael Pilardi now as he's on to punt for Green Bay. Fielded at the 33. And a penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward. Seahawks with a first and 10. Locke gets ready to go. On their side of midfield at the 47. They fake the handoff. Now Locke. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Multiple defenders in there to bring him down as this quarter comes to an end. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. This is caught inside the 15. And a loose football. And the Packers pick it up.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail by two scores in the fourth, and their defense did its job getting the fumble recovery. Time to see what this offense has left in the tank. And he'll manage to break a tackle and get this forward for a couple. It'll be second down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, "My bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there."
And they'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher, third down and 9.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks, and now here's a tackle behind the line.
And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Tyreek Smith, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Now Rodgers, got to have this one. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. Well, I guess an interception at this point on fourth down is just as bad as an incomplete pass. Either way, the ball goes over to the other side.
Yeah, it's a tough spot to be in this late in the game, and there's not a whole lot he could do there, and he winds up giving the ball away.
Play action, lock. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Mike Evans, his third touchdown of the game, number 16 on the season. And the Seahawks add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Extra point right down the middle, and that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this, because even the best of the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you, and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. He'll get this to about the 38.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
On second down, they'll run it here. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. Now Rodgers. Rodgers a free play. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Raekwon McMillan.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
So that last penalty making this third down much more manageable. Third down, 4 yards to go. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
Textbook coverage right there. Played the ball, never lost sight of where it was headed, and stayed in perfect position to make a play on it. Able to keep the receiver and the quarterback in his sight lines.
Gonna go on fourth down, and this time he's got the hookup. It's complete, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. From midfield, here's Rodgers. Griffin's got it, middle of the field. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. They'll come up now on second and a yard.
26.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Caleb Farley. And the Seahawks will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance at victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly is on the defense's side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly. And what a benefit for them, able to pick that one off.
Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And all the way in, touchdown, Sam. Now the try here for the point after. And that PAT pushes the lead up to 23 now. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to... Now look out, Rodgers lost the football, and the Seahawks have picked it up. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And it looks like this will be the last play before the two-minute warning. Following the fumble recovery, it's Locke. Blitz coming, and down he goes. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. They'll actually throw it with Locke.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone.
And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Locke. And he fires one that's intercepted. And the Packers will have solid field position here as they take over at the 45-yard line. Well, these defensive coaches, they sure like what they've got in this rookie corner. And with good reason, as you saw there.
He only cost him a day two pick, and a lot of people thought he had first-round ability. But when he was available on draft night, that was one where you didn't need the full time to make the selection. You call that pick in early, and it shows why he was so coveted with that interception there.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A big pickup of 38. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back, they can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Rolling, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down.
Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Spencer. Touchdown! From 21 yards away. And the Packers get a bit closer.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team. But I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film. But this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
Rodgers will throw for it. Complete at the one. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because of the back of the end zone. Never let a guy catch one in front of you.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they just continue to roll right along, really. This has the looks of yet another victory as they hope to polish it off here in quarter number four. He's got a man complete. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play, so it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lamb.
Well, this was a very close ball game at halftime, Charles, but in the second half, that offense kind of kicked things into another gear, and they were able to pull away for the victory.
And, Brandon, I think they're the type of team that just looked in the mirror and said, hey, ton of pressure on, but we're the type of team that can flat out handle it. They stood up with confidence, and made it happen for a victory.
So for the Seahawks, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And they'll have another road date next week with the Carolina Panthers. Meanwhile, for the Packers, add another loss to the pile as they drop to 2-8 now on the year. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to MetLife Stadium to take on the New York Giants.